How's it going, everyone? I'm Landon with LMR.com. In today's video, we're gonna be taking a closer look at Aeromotive's heavy duty fuel pump wiring kit, as well as explain some basic setup information. That way you have a better idea as to how this wiring kit is used in a Fox Body Mustang. If we take a closer look at the wiring harness, you'll immediately notice Aeromotive's great attention to detail. Each wire is wrapped with mesh wire loom and then secured with heavy duty heat shrink to ensure that the mesh loom doesn't fray. Now the big question here is why I need this wiring harness. Well, with the higher amp draw from aftermarket fuel pumps, such as Aeromotive's 340 liter per hour pump, the factory wiring size is not sufficient enough to handle the amp draw, which is why you see 10 gauge wire used in this harness. This wiring harness consists of a 30 amp weather resistant automotive relay, a 4 foot 10 gauge red power wire with integrated 30 amp circuit breaker, a 1 foot 10 gauge black ground wire, a 10 foot 16 gauge trigger wire, an 18 foot 10 gauge red and black wire for fuel pump power and ground, two insulated butt connectors, two ring terminals for a number 10 stud, one large ring terminal for a 3/8 stud, 12 6-inch zip ties, and three self-tapping screws. Now, just because they provide the accessories, feel free to use your own ring terminals or wire management components, since a lot of us have different setups. So because of everyone's personal expectations and unique setups, I like to categorize wiring as a quote-unquote custom install. Now, what I mean by that is that the placement of the relay and the wiring is a case-by-case basis. Some of you will still have a push rod, and some of you will have a Coyote. Moving forward with the basic steps, I am going to do my best to explain where each connection needs to be made, and I'll be referencing Fox Body Mustangs. Before you begin, make sure you have a strong understanding of electrical systems. If you don't, I would highly recommend the assistance from a knowledgeable friend or have a trustworthy local performance shop do this for you. You want to lay out the harness and familiarize yourself with everything, and then plan a method of attack of how you want to run the harness. Per the Aeromotive instructions, you first need to find a suitable place to mount the supplied relay. They want the main power wire with the circuit breaker as close to the battery as possible for optimal circuit protection. Depending on your setup, this can connect to the battery itself, the battery side of the starter solenoid, the lug on the alternator, or if you have a Coyote swap, this wire can't connect to the main power lug in the fuse box. This wire can be cut to length if desired. If it is cut, make sure to wrap the end of the mesh loom with electrical tape or use your own heat shrink to prevent the end from fraying. Install the provided large ring terminal onto the red power wire. Next, you need to find a suitable ground for the short black ground wire. Wherever you ground this, make sure the ground is clean and free of paint, rust, or corrosion. Now you need to run the two long 18 foot 10 gauge fuel pump wires to the rear of the car. You can run these wires through the car or underneath, so pick your poison. If you run these underneath the car, make sure they are free of moving parts, exhaust components, and road obstructions or debris. Don't run these wires alongside the fuel lines. Once you reach the rear of the car, you can cut these wires to length if needed. Again, make sure you wrap or reheat shrink the mesh loom. Depending on what fuel pump assembly is in your car, you'll have the option to use the supplied ring terminals or the butt connectors. The car we have in the shop today does have an Aeromotive 340 liter per hour fuel pump assembly, and it utilizes studs as the electrical attaching point for the fuel pump. Make sure you connect the red wire with the positive stud and the black wire with the negative stud. Wiring this the wrong way will cause the fuel pump to run backwards. Now we need to wire the trigger wire on the Aeromotive relay. If you're still utilizing factory Fox Body wiring with a pushrod engine, you can use the factory fuel pump wire as the trigger. Doing this will utilize the inertia switch, which is highly recommended. In the event of a crash, the plunger in the inertia switch is released, which kills power to the fuel pump. The factory fuel pump relay is either under the driver's seat if you have a 1986 to 1991 EFI car, or near the mass air meter if you have a 1992 or 1993 car. Whatever you do, don't get the fuel pump relay confused with the wide open throttle shutoff relay for the AC compressor if you have a 92 to 93 car, as the relays are right next to each other. 1986 to 1991 cars can utilize the factory fuel pump wire from the relay under the driver's seat. This is typically a pink wire with black tracer, but you can also confirm this with a multimeter. The fuel pump wire will show 12 volt key on and then drop to zero. You can also confirm this by checking the wire at the fuel pump itself. Cut the factory fuel pump wire and splice the Aeromotive trigger wire into the relay side on the factory wire. You'll need to supply your own butt connectors, heat shrink, or solder for this. You can simply use a piece of heat shrink or electrical tape on the unused end of the factory fuel pump wire. Now for 1992 and 1993 cars, you'll need to run the Aeromotive 12 volt trigger wire to the rear of the car. If needed, this can be extended. Because of the circuit differences from the earlier cars, the inertia switch is wired after the relay on the later cars. Locate the factory fuel pump wiring at the rubber grommet on the passenger side of the spare tire well. This wire is typically pink with a black tracer. Cut the wire and connect the Aeromotive 12 volt trigger wire to the side of the factory wire that is running to the inertia switch. Use a butt connector or solder and insulate the splice with heat shrink. The unused end can be wrapped with electrical tape or use heat shrink. Now for those of you that have a Coyote setup and you're not utilizing the factory wiring, you'll need to either rewire the inertia switch or wire in an inertia switch. The 12 volt positive fuel pump wire from the Coyote controls pack will need to be connected to the input side of the inertia switch, and the 12 volt trigger wire from the Aeromotive harness will need to be connected to the output side of the inertia switch. Once all the wiring is complete, make sure the harness is properly secured and then test the vehicle for proper fuel pump operation. All right, I know that was a lot of information. If it helps, feel free to watch the video a few more times to have a better understanding. Again, if this is something you are not comfortable with, please reach out to a professional. Other than that, if you're comfortable with wiring, this one should be a breeze. As always, for the most up-to-date product information, pricing, and availability on anything in the video, please reference LMR.com. If you like this video or it helped you out, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Fox Body Mustang content and turn on notifications. That way you're notified every time we release something new. Until next time, you guys know what to do. For all things Fox Body, keep it right here with the real enthusiasts, LMR.com.